Hi all, today we are going to discuss about extension of range of ammeters using shunts as well as the swamping resistor. So we have seen in the last class the amount of the current that can be passed through the moving coil is limited to about 20 milliamperes due to the weight constraints, because the weight of the moving part should be minimum in order to decrease the value of the friction. And the second one, the current carrying capacity of the spiral springs. Because in the case of PMMC instrument, you can see in this instrument, there will be springs will be used. The purpose of the spiral springs is twofold. One is providing the required controlling torque as well as carrying the current, leading the current from the external circuit into the moving coil. So because of the current carrying capacity limitation of this spring also, we cannot go beyond 20 milliamperes. So, but 20 milliamperes is not there. In practice, we may need to measure the large value of the current. So how to measure it? So for that, what we will do? So to increase the range of the ammeter, a low value of resistance must be connected in parallel with the meter. So that value of the resistor is called as the shunt resistor, or simply it is called as the shunt. So by using the shunt, we can extend the range of the instrument up to about 50 amperes. And if you want to increase the value beyond this limit, generally we go for the current transformer, or they are also called as instrument transformers. So using the current transformer, we step down the voltage, then we will use the instrument for measurement. So that we have already discussed in instrument transformers. In transformers playlist, you can check there if you have the doubt. Or even we have discussed in the measurements playlist also. So now coming to the operation. So out of the total current I, some current will pass through your shunt resistor and some shunt current will pass through your meter. So by using the current division rule, we can tell the current passing through the meter Im will be equal to I into other resistance by total resistance. This is I into RSH divided by RSH plus RM. Or from this, out of this, this RSH plus RM divided by RSH. So this I can, from this I can obtain it as I by Im, because this I bring Im here. So this entire term I bring to the second side. So this I by Im is called as the multiplication factor. So this is the ratio of total current or the input current divided by current that is actually passing through the meter. So this I am going to use in the remaining derivation. So please remember this. So now I am proceeding further. So this RSH plus RM I can cross multiply with Im. So Im multiplied by RSH plus RM is equal to I into RSH. Or from this, I can separate the RSH part separate and RM part separate. So what I am doing, this Im into RSH I brought to the second side. This will become RSH into I minus Im is coming to the second side. I minus Im is equal to what is remaining here? Im multiplied by RM. So Im multiplied by RM. So from this, I can write RSH is equal to Im RM by I minus Im. Or from this, I can write RM divided by this Im I am bringing to the denominator. So this will be I by Im minus Im by Im. So this I by Im, we know it is nothing but equal to multiplication factor M. So this will be RM divided by M minus 1. This is the basic formula for calculating the value of shunt resistance required. So this we will take one example. So this will be clarified there. So let us see what are the properties of the shunt resistor that are required. So the shunt resistor, should have low temperature coefficient and low thermal EMF with the copper. And so practically we go for the mangan end for the case of PMMC type of instrument. And if you want to use your instrument for the case of AC instrument, like other type of instrument we are going to discuss in coming lectures, we go for constant end. This is also sometimes asked in the competitive exams. For DC, mangan end is used. For AC, constant N is used in practice. So the resistance of the shunt should not vary with respect to the time. So the advantage of this mangan N or constant N is they are having very less temperature coefficient of resistance. So now if you are taking your instrument, this is my meter resistance and this is my shunt resistance. We have already seen that the shunt resistance, that it is made up of mangan N, but practically the meter winding is made up of copper. So temperature coefficient of both these materials are different. So whenever the temperature is changed, so the change in the resistance of these two values will be different. That means the change in RM will be different, RSH will be different. So the ratio of RM and RSH is completely disturbed. Because as the ratio is disturbed, automatically the current division is disturbed and this will lead to the errors. So in order to understand this concept, I am going to discuss one numerical. There you will understand the concept in complete detail there. I will take the case of swamping resistor and without swamping resistor and explain this concept. So In order to avoid the effect of these temperature variations, this meter resistance also should be made up of same type of material as this shunt resistor. So shunt resistor is made up of manganin. So what we will do, we will connect some resistor in series with the meter. That means inside here one resistor will be connected in series with the meter. That meter is, that resistance is called as a swamping resistor. So this swamping resistor is made up of manganin. So what we will do in practice, so here one resistor will be connected here. So total Rm will be sum of meter resistance, that means resistance of the winding, plus swamping resistor resistance. So this value of the swamping resistor is generally taken as 20 to 30 times the value of the resistance of the coil, so that the effect of increase in this resistance due to temperature variations will be neglected, because this is dominating when compared to meter resistance. So this also will be cleared when we are discussing the numerical in the coming section. So then let us see how can we go for the multi-range ammeter. Single range we have seen. So some cases in the instrument you will see more than one range will be there. Depending on your requirement you will connect. Let us take for example, I want to use one instrument to measure 1 ampere, 10 ampere, 20 ampere as well as 50 ampere. So for that case, for measuring different ranges, I need different resistors, different value of shunt. So that I am representing RSH1, RSH2, RSH3 and RSH4 are used for measuring the currents of I1, I2, I3 and I4. These are the current range or the maximum value of the current that passes. So let us take the ratio of M1 is a ratio of I1 by IM. Similarly, M2 is I2 by IM, M3 is IT by IM and M4 is I4 by IM. So at a time only one resistor is connected to the circuit. So I can calculate that resistance because derivation is already made before. So RSH will be equal to RM by M minus 1. So here M will depend on which particular position the switch is connected. Because according to our current range, we will keep the respective location. So this will be M1 minus 1. RSH2 will be RM by M2 minus 1. RSH3 is RM by M3 minus 1. RSH4 is RM by M4 minus 1. But the disadvantage of this one is the multiple resistors are required for extending the range. And the second one, during the changing the position of the switch. So whenever you are changing from position number 1 to position number 2. So for that much duration, what happens? The switch is open circuit, or we can tell that ISH is equal to 0. That means whatever the total current is coming, that current will pass through your meter. So whenever that much use current is passing through your meter will spoil or your coil will damage. So in order to avoid this, we have to go for make before break switch. That means when you are moving from position number 1 to position number 2, until you switch your position to position number 2, the switch will remain in position number 1 also. So after connecting to switch to position number 2, then 2 will be connected and 1 will be open circuited. So in that way, always one resistor will be connected across your meter. So that's why your instrument will not damage. This is the basic precaution that should be taken. That is one approach. Or second approach, we can go for the universal shunt, also called as Earshunt shunt. So the disadvantage that is mentioned above is avoided in this case. So in this case, what will be there? A single resistor will be used. So multiple resistors are not required. So size requirement will be less and cost requirement will be less. So tappings will be taken on this resistor only. Let us assume total resistance of this resistance is R1. So tapping is taken at position number 2. So resistance will be R2. Up to tapping at position number 3, resistance is equal to R3. So now, depending on the range, I will connect my switch to either position number 1 or position number 2 or position number 3. Let us assume the currents will be I1, I2 and I3. Depending on the current range, I will connect to respective. So let us try to calculate. So when the switch is at position number 1, when you are connecting to position number 1, you can see I1 is coming up to here. So out of this I1, one current is passing through the meter, that is IM. So the voltage across your meter will be IM multiplied by RM. And this I1 minus IM, that current is passing through this whole resistance, that is equal to R1. So same thing I am writing, I1 minus IM times of R1 is equal to IM times of RM. That means voltage across two parallel circuits is same. So from this I can write R1 is equal to RM by M1 minus 1, where the value of M1 will be equal to I1 by IM. Similarly, if the switch is at position number 2, so the current I2 will come. So one current will pass, that meter current IM will pass through this channel. So in this channel you can see now this resistance is also added to your meter. That means in the meter total resistance will be up to here it is R1, up to here it is R2. That means the value of this piece will be R1 minus R2 plus Rm. So same thing I have mentioned here, R1 minus R2 plus Rm times of Im will be equal to I2 minus Im times of R2, because this second path will be R2. So now this can be simplified. When you are simplifying this, it will become R2 I2 is equal to Im into R1 plus Rm, or from this R2 will be R1 plus Rm by I2 by Im. This I2 by Im I am taking as M2. So similarly, when you are keeping at position number 3, so this entire resistor is added to your meter. So in the meter, resistance will be R1 minus R3 plus Rm times of Im will be equal to I3 minus Im times of R3. Agree with me? Remaining current is passing through this. So same equation I have written here, and then solved it. I got the value of R3 is equal to Rm plus R1 divided by M3. No need to mug up. You can easily solve in the exam if it is given there. So let us take two examples to understand this concept clearly. First one, a 0 to 1 milliampere moving coil ammeter has an internal resistance of 5 ohms. Calculate the value of shunt resistor required to extend the range of instrument to 100 amperes. So we have to extend the range to 100 amperes. I is equal to 100. So meter current is given as 1 milliampere and the value of meter resistance is 5 ohms. So we know the value of M is equal to I by Im. This is multiplication factor. So this is 100 by Im is 1 milli. So 100 by 1 milli will be equal to 100 kilo. So 100 kilo is coming. So the value of RSH is Rm by M minus 1. That is 5 divided by 100k minus 1. So you will get it as approximately 50 micro ohms. So RSH value required is 50 micro ohms. So now you will understand that why copper is not used, because you will get doubt as the meter resistance is, meter is made up of copper. We can make shunt also with copper. So then the effect of temperature variation is negligible, because both will rise with the same percentage with change in the temperature. But problem is, we cannot get this much less value of resistance using the copper. So if you want to go for extreme low value of resistances, that is not possible with copper. So that's why we have to go for the other type of materials. So I think that manganese and why we are using is clear to you now. So let us take the example of swamping resistor. What is the effect? So a moving coil instrument has a resistance of 5 ohms between the terminals, and full scale deflection is obtained with a current of 0.02 amperes. So this instrument is to be used with the manganese and shunt to measure 100 amperes. So range is extended to 100 amperes by using some manganese shunt. So calculate the error caused by a 15 degree centigrade rise in the temperature when the internal resistance of 5 ohms due to the copper only is used. That means the meter resistance is 5 ohms, which is due to copper only. And second case, when a 4 ohms manganese swamping resistor in series with 1 ohm copper resistance is used in the coil. That means coil is having two parts. One is due to the copper 1 ohm, and due to manganese 4 ohms is used. Both cases resistance of the meter is same. So now taking the temperature coefficient of resistance of copper is 0.4% per degree centigrade, and whereas for the case of manganese it is very less, you can see it is 0.015% per degree centigrade. It is nearly negligible. So now first I have noted down the given data. It is mentioned Rm is equal to 5 ohms, Im is 0.02 amperes, current is given as 100 amperes, so we can write the value multiplication factor M is equal to I by Im, 100 by 0.02, which is 5000. So the value of RSH required will be Rm by M minus 1, so 5 by 5000 minus 1, this is 0.001 ohms. So now the shunt resistance after a rise of 15 degree centigrade will be, because R2 is equal to R1 into 1 plus alpha into T2 minus T1, or otherwise we can tell that R initial value of resistance is 0.01 multiplied by 1 plus the temperature change. The temperature change is 15 degrees multiplied by alpha. Alpha is given by 0.015%. So percentage means we have to divide with 100 to get the per unit value. I have divided by 100. So this is the value I got. So now going to the instrument only with the copper. That means instrument is having a resistance of 5 ohms, only copper is used. So that resistance will be equal to 5 into 1 plus temperature changes 15 multiplied by temperature coefficient is 0.4%. This is 0.4 by 100. It will become equal to 5.3 ohms. 0.3 ohms is increased by increasing 15 degrees centigrade. So now current through the instrument will be equal to, so 100, because current through the instrument is I into other resistance by total resistance. So 100 multiplied by shunt resistance value we have calculated. This is the updated value, divided by shunt resistance plus meter resistance. So updated value. So you will get this value of the current. So amount of the error in the reading will be measured value or the current that is coming, that is, this is a measured value. Actually, or ideally, we need 0.02. So, actual value minus ideal value by ideal value into 100. So, this will be equal to minus 5.46%. Or otherwise, we can tell that instead of reading 100 amperes, your meter will read 100 minus 5.46% means 5.46 by 100 multiplied by 100. So, your meter will read 94.534 amperes. That means when 100 amperes is given to the instrument, your meter is reading 94.534 amperes. It is having the error. That minus is indicating that only. So, the taking the case of a swamping resistor, here the swamping resistor is taken in the ratio 1:4. But in practice, I told you it will be very high, up to 30 times will be used. So, it will be much more extra compensation. Just to tell an example, I have taken the ratio 1:4, the worst possible case. So, here, the first case, the copper is having 1 multiplied by 1 plus 15 into temperature coefficient is 0.4 by 100 or 0.004. Second one is manganese is used of 4 ohms. So, 4 into 1 plus 15 into 0.015 divided by 100. This will be 0.00015. So, this term will be 1.06 plus 4.009. So, you will get it as 5.069 ohms. So, in the previous case, you got 5.3 ohms. So, you can see now it is decreased to 5.069 ohms. So, now let us calculate the current passing through the meter is, if you are substituting, it will become 0.019768 amperes, or error you will get as minus 1.158%. Previous case we got minus 5.6, here it is decreased to 1.16%. That means the error is decreased, or otherwise for 100 amperes of input current, your meter previously displacing 94.53 amperes, but now it will show 98.84 amperes. You can see the error is decreased drastically. So instead of 4:1 ratio, if you are going from 30:1 ratio, so what will happen? So, even this error will decrease further. So, effect of temperature will be nullified nearly almost completely. So, from this we can conclude that the error is decreased by using the swamping resistor made up of same material as the shunt, that is nothing but equal to manganese is used in practice. I hope that the concept of the shunt, how to extend the range of the ammeter, is completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.